killing them. It's homicide, I'm killing them. It's homicide, I got my change up, they looking like they surprised. Niggas hating on me hard cause my paper ride, but I'm killing them. It's homicide, I'm killing them. It's homicide, I got my waves when I was young, so I tend to
Benzo, Batman, Big Ho, Lap Dance, Ass so fat, need a lap dance, Ass so fat, I need a lap dance, Benzo, Batman, Big Ho, Lap Dance, Ass so fat, need
Leg out. Yellow model chick, yellow bottle sippin', yellow Lamborghini, yellow top missing. Yeah, yeah, that shit look like a toupee. I get what you get in 10 years, in 2 days. Ladies love me, I'm on my cool J. If you get what I get,
cause one of us goes in and we all go through it. And Drizzy got the money, so Drizzy gon' pay it. Those my brothers, I ain't even gotta say it. That's just something they know. They know, they know, they know. They know, they know, they know. They know, they know, they know. Yeah, they know, yeah.
I'm a beast on the mic when I speak, what I write. Speed to the site, OZ in a pipe. I don't give a fuck if my jeans too tight. Don't worry about me, go live your life. Just too nice, rock it ill. No auto-tune, just lots of skill. Crazy, so says Dr. Phil. Roll one up and pop a pill. Do what I do when I rap for the 2 to the O to the 3. I gotta do. Never hold back when the words I spew. Through my mouth, aim right at you. Through and through, I'm that. You don't wanna try that. Can't see me like your own eyelash. Snap it.
Ride with the stick, puffin' on a perp. Overtime on you niggas, gonna work, work. I'm gonna work, work. I'm gonna work, work. Overtime on you niggas, cause I'm gonna work, work. I'm gonna get it in the means necessary. Cause you know I'm by my paper like a secretary. I'm gonna work, work. I'm gonna work, work. I'm gonna work, work.
Strong will survive, yeah. And if your heart is steel, then you and I will collide, yeah.
We gon' rush at each other like two rams fighting in the grasslands, yeah. And I'ma be the last man standing. My nigga, I'm a beast. I can do 30 days and nights when the
see you driving around town with the girl I love, and I'm like, forget. Wasn't enough. I'm like, forget you and forget her too. Said if I was richer, I'd still be with you. Wait, that's a shh. That's a shh. And all the
so we're here with Nick Coletta. Congratulations last year on your championship victory.
Thank you.
So how are you feeling this year about the tournament with your first pick? Let's talk about your picks a little bit.
Well, my first pick was Eddie White. I had him a couple years ago. I saw last year him and Tom. I also have Tom Soka, brought Mike Dorman to the championship. Of course, they didn't win, but they did get him there. So I think with me, you know, being that much better than Mike Dorman, I think us three will be able to take us to the championship. And I also got Garrett Barry, the Garrett Barry, as Dylan Citron would say. So I think we'll be all right.
All right, Nick, how are you feeling? I know we have a little injury. The media hasn't released that yet on your wrist. How are you going to be feeling for the tournament, you think?
Oh, you know, I was taking a little batting practice tonight. I was a little sore, but come game day, I'll be ready to go. No questions asked.
All right, Nick, good luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, we're here with Dylan Citron. Dylan, how are you feeling about this year's tournament?
I'm feeling good. I'm a good team. I had the first pick in the draft, and I got a great player.
All right, so let's talk about that. Who did you pick first round?
Ryan Kenny. The Ryan Kenny.
Okay, let's talk about Ryan. What do you like in Ryan that you think? Now, Dylan, I mean, it's hard to say this, but you have one win. You broke the curse last year. What do you think Ryan's going to bring you maybe to get to a championship this year?
He's going to bring me everything he's got. He can pitch. He can hit. He can kind of run. He's not the fastest person, but hit it out of the ballpark. You don't have to run.
Ryan, let's talk about your other picks. Pitchers, batters, who do you have otherwise?
Got Scott Davern, pretty fast guy. And Corey Tolmay, the Tolminator. Tolminator's going to be big this year.
All right, man. Hey, good luck to you this year. I hope you get to the championship.
Well, I'm going
to
win it.
We're here with Devin Tolmay, 2007 Pitcher of the Year, a while back. Devin, congratulations as a captain. Talk to us about your picks and how you're going to succeed this year.
Start off, I didn't have that high of a pick, but I got lucky and your brother, Ryan McLaughlin, was still there. Then my second pick was Danny Mills. I played with him on a couple of travel teams and he surprised me recently. He's gotten a lot better. Finally, my last pick was... It wasn't an easy pick, but I did it. Damon Marine.
He's
gonna pull through big time for us this year.
So, and your wing is gonna be in full force, right, for the tournament?
Wing?
Your arm. Your pitching. Your wing. Come on.
Duck wing?
Jeez. Yeah, the Oregon Duck wing. And I think that's a yes. Thanks, Devin Tolmay. Good luck. We're here with Dylan Martin. Welcome to the Wiffle Ball Draft. With the 9th pick, kind of deep pick, but let's talk about your picks.
Picked Dan Tweeney. He fell to me. I was surprised he was still there. He could hit it out of the park, not a bad pick. And then Russ is still there. He was the first overall pick a couple years ago. And Fred Johnson, he's a good guy, decent player, but I had a late pick. So I was happy with what I got.
So are you feeling a championship season this year? Are you feeling semifinal? What are you feeling?
I think I could go to championship, but no less than top three is a failure.
Okay, man. Hey, good luck to you. I hope you do well. We'll see you on the cul-de-sac. We're here with A.J. Marauer, the 2010 Underrated Player of the Year. A.J., after two walk-off home runs in the tournament, one by me, by the way, walk-off grand slam. How do you feel in this year as being a captain and trying to lead a team?
I feel that I'm going to make it big this year.
You're going to make it big? Okay,
yeah.
That doesn't make much sense. Here we go. First pick. Let's talk about your picks. Who do you have?
My first pick.
Oh, wow. Are you serious?
Wait, who is my friend? Oh, John Sudol.
Okay.
John Sudol.
And what do you think? I mean, last year he crapped the bed a little bit. What? Yeah.
I think he crapped the bed because he had his own team and he didn't know what he was
doing. All right. So you think he's gonna be phenomenal this year?
Yeah, he's gonna do a lot better this year.
All right. And just name your two other guys. We're running out of time here.
My other two guys are JoJo Tolmay and Sergio Espinosa.
All right. I don't know why you're laughing at Sergio, but hey, good luck to you. Hopefully you're pitching against me. And we'll see you next.
That's why I picked a good pitcher.
We'll see you out in the cul-de-sac, buddy. Good luck. We're here with Tyler Doyle at the Hagler Court Wiffle Ball Draft. Tyler, let's talk about your picks this year and who you picked first and all your picks and how they're going to work out for you.
My first pick, I had to go with Pat Minchurin. You know, I noticed he was lifting weights a lot, so I feel like he could hit one out of the park this year.
Right, and let's go back to a couple years ago. I'm sure the fans want to hear about this. When the Bleacher Creatures, I want to talk about them. Are they going to affect you this year, especially since you're a captain?
They could affect me this year more. You know, I got that temper in me, so it probably will come out just because, you know, they'll get to me. So.
Hey, you gotta get it past you. And who else do you have? You have Pat, Zach, and Andrew, right?
Yep, Zach.
So, hey, hopefully you guys go far this year. I wish you the luck, and I'll see you out in the cul-de-sac, man.
Thank you.
We're here with Mike Doran. Mike, how are you?
I'm doing alright. How you doing?
Hey, I'm fine. You know, I mean, it's great to have you back here.
It's good to be back.
Yeah. Let's talk about your pick. You got very lucky, I must say.
I did.
Let's talk about that.
Well, my first pick was Tim Rogers. It was surprising that I actually had the second pick overall, but he was my first pick, Tim Rogers. My second was Goff, and my third was Jalen. I rolled the dice on Jalen.
Hey, we'll see what he does, right?
Yeah,
well, I mean,
give him a chance.
Yeah. Let's talk about last year. Came up short. Let Galetta win his first championship, which we are all shaking our heads at.
Right.
And
I'll be looking for a little redemption on Galetta.
He took your guy last year, Eddie White, who you were very excited about.
He actually took my whole team.
Right. So I mean, that would be a good. I would love to see that in a semifinal matchup.
We'll see what happens.
I mean,
I'm looking forward to it.
I'm looking forward to this day too. Mike Dorland here. Good luck to you. We'll see you out in the cul-de-sac.
All right, see you later.
We're here at Mike Lloyd. Mike, it's great not to see you limping this year.
It's working great.
Oh, that's great, Kai. All right. We are going to talk about your picks. Let's talk about your first pick this year.
First pick right out the gate is Jeremy Carney. He is clutch.
You guys now reunited with the Pink Team, as I must say.
Yep, 2 years ago.
2 years ago. So,
with AJ.
Right, good chemistry. Talk about your other picks now for us.
I took Joe Johnson. I'm expecting big things from him. He's a new guy. Same with Dylan Barry.
He's an athletic kid. They're both athletic kids.
Young, old, you know, it's going to be good.
Right. As I'm looking at it now, Lloyd, you have a very talented team. You might be the favorite this year.
Yep, I'm looking for some good offensive.
Right, you might, and some speed, especially.
Yeah, that's
so, good luck to you this year. Third place 2 years in a row. It's time for you to get your championship, man. I'm rooting for you, seriously, though. I was last year, too.
Yep.
All right, man.
Winner or loser, I'm a winner.
You're a winner. All right, see you on the cul-de-sac.
All right, we're with Dan McLaughlin here. What were your first picks?
I got Zach Hay. This year I got the 10th pick, which was unfortunate for me. Of course, my tournament, I get this bad luck. Everybody doesn't want me to win. I got Zach Hay. I got two picks in a row, Zach Hay and Brandon Fairbanks, who I might add was the rookie of the year last year, so I'm expecting big things from these both guys. And I also got John Morton at the end. So
are you feeling pretty confident?
I feel confident every year, Mike. I come out, I drink a cup of coffee, I come out to that cul-de-sac, I got glory running in my blood. Two championships, two.
Are you looking for another?
How you feeling? Next year I'm going to cry because it's the last year, I might
say.
I am looking for another. I'm always looking for a number. I'm always hungry.
The tournament's winded down, man.
I meant another. I'm a little nervous. Hey, good luck to everybody. I go out there, I have fun. I do this for you guys. I stress out, but it's all fun in the end. All
right, those are the words of Dan McLaughlin. Hey, good to hear from you.
See you out in the cul-de-sac. All
right. Boys in the polos, entrepreneur niggas in the mogos. He can ball with the cool, he can sell loud. But I think I like him better when he dole out. And I think I like him better with the fitted cap on. He ain't even gotta try to put the Mac on. He just gotta give me that look. When he give me that look, then the penny's coming off. Excuse me, you're a hell of a guy. You know I really got a thing for American guys. I mean, sigh, sickening eyes. I can tell that you're in touch with your feminine side. Yes, I did, yes, I did. Somebody please tell him who the F I is. I am Nicki Minaj, I'm Mac and Dude's up. Back coops up and chuck the deuce up.